project's been here since 1979. We're a community development project, and basically we provide a range of services primarily aimed at young people and older people in the community, and hopefully we encourage self-help initiatives.
Well, Pilmeny is a key example of a local voluntary organisation that feeds extremely productively into what happens here in Leith in terms of maintaining well-being and people's sense of belonging. They have been adventurous and innovative in the way they've developed work with older people, and particularly older men, who are a very reluctant client group, not often easy to get them involved with things, but they have been really successful.
I suppose health in its broadest sense ties into this work, because it's about the older men's mental health and well-being, it's about their physical health and well-being, and it's about a preventative approach to helping older people stay in their own homes for longer. As they get older, it's about helping with the social care needs and supporting each other so they don't need to make demands upon the more expensive services.
The health promotion part is brought about by a series of weekly programmes of events and activities. And what I do normally is every 3 months or so we have an evaluation, sort of evaluation session, see how everybody's doing, how they're liking it, how can we improve it.
They have young persons programmes, they have specific older people's programmes, they have an older men's group, they have a women's group, they have a forum for older people where their views about what's happening in the area, what services, what they need can be expressed. So they respond a lot to consultations, and when local authority or the NHS wants to find out what people's views are, they're very organised in getting that fed back in.
Actually, the guys see it as more of a club than a health and wellbeing group, because they're always saying, oh, I'm coming down to the club on Wednesday, which is nice because it means that they actually enjoy coming and they sort of own it, so therefore they feel part of it.
It was recommended that I come here because I was very isolated and lonely and I didn't want to associate with anybody, and said that men's groups were not for me, just, you know, not interested at all.
It affects my life in quite a number of ways, being here, because my wife died 5 years ago and I'd been a full-time carer for 9 years previous to that, so I found myself at a loose end.
Since then, it's basically transformed my life. It really has been an eye-opener. It's been a focus for me to get out the house and to look forward to being with other people.
I come here every Wednesday, and then from there we've now developed into another group which is called the Intergenerational Group, which is where the senior citizens like myself meet the teenagers who are sort of between 12 to 15 on a Friday afternoon down in another part of Leith.
We've already won an award from Edinburgh Council for the innovative approach to this thing, and I think it helps an awful lot of people. Because, as I say, it demystifies different people at different ages, and we'll all identify each other now as individuals.
What the group gives to each other is peer support, confidence, knowledge.
A lot of evidence shows that when people have that sense of belonging, it feeds into their improves their physical health as well as their mental well-being.
The older men's group's only one project which falls under the Pilmeny umbrella. There are also a women's group, there's a mixed group, then we have a youth worker who runs youth groups, so we've got youth work going on as well. As an organisation, I think it's absolutely wonderful.
We've worked very closely to develop a project, Millen Senior Welfare Organisation, which is services and daycare for older people from Indian, Pakistani, Bangladeshi and Mauritian communities. We've developed a similar project called MECOP, which is for minority ethnic carers of older people, and it has now extended to people of all ages.
I think Pilmeny is probably held up as an example of good practice because they do a number of things well. For instance, they have programs for older people and for younger people, and then they've brought those together. A lot of organizations will concentrate on one particular age group. Pilmeny have actually tried to integrate those two.
And I think as part of our project's ethos, we very much see having representation and inclusion of all communities and ages as being absolutely fundamental to our work.
What I've tried to do is make sure that organisations in the area can actually get together and learn from each other and share that experience.
Another aspect of CHEX work that we are still involved with at the moment is a new pilot project to support voluntary organisations with a mentoring scheme, and that's been really good because it's given us an opportunity to access a service that our project could never have afforded to do on our own, and hopefully will help to improve the quality of our work.
And a development project like this has a very useful role in supporting other organisations to get to start running programmes and projects that benefit local people as well.
One of the ways in which CHEX promotes the sharing of good practice between community-led organisations themselves and between these organisations and their partners is through the organisation of events such as the CHEX seminars and national conference. We consult with network members around what the key practice issues are for them in relation to community-led health, and we use this to inform the themes of the seminars. So they might be around, for example, community-led research, health improvement topics, or methods for demonstrating impact around community-led approaches. The CHEX events create an opportunity for community-led organisations to come together to share learning, and we try to maximise that learning by identifying the outcomes for the events with CHEX network members and by using methods that allow organisations to share ideas and experiences. CHEX uses a number of different mediums to alert network members to information around publications, policy and resources and practice development. CHEX produces a quarterly newsletter called CHEX Point, and that's the main vehicle for promoting good practice and addressing key issues around the policy agenda. CHEX Point currently goes out to over 1,800 members, and we're hoping to increase that readership when we merge CHEX Point with another publication of ours, Engage magazine, which will bring more of the kind of policy debate into CHEX Point.